You can use the same sleeves the best players in the world use, Channel Fireball sleeves. And what better way to carry them than in a Channel Fireball deck box? And if you want to play like the best, you have to dress like the best. Channel Fireball shirts, hats, hoodies, and more are all available in the apparel section of ChannelFireball.com. Head to ChannelFireball.com/store to find all of your gaming supplies.
Hey everyone, welcome to the Holiday Cube Draft. We've got a sweet little card called Treachery. There's also Tezzeret, Agent of Bolas, which got a lot better because of the increased number of artifacts in the cube. And so I think what we're going to do is just start with Treachery, though, because all good turns start with Treachery. It is a bit more on the fair side in terms of, you know, it's interacting with creatures, but it certainly is a good one. So we'll start with that. And this pack is a little less interesting. There's Venser, which is pretty cool as Treachery. There's also Flooded Strand and Sylvan Caryatid. But I think I like Venser and Flooded Strand the most. And what we have to do is decide which one we want. Now, Flooded Strand is going to work out with whatever color combination that we end up getting, because there are a lot of dual lands between the original cycle and the Ravnica cycle. So 20 dual lands possible. Granted, Overgrown Tomb doesn't work with them, but Overgrown Tomb isn't necessarily going to be working with Treachery. I think this is pretty tough. And there are a lot of Enter the Battlefield triggers, but I think this guy's just a little bit fair, and I'm going to take the Flooded Strand, because it gives us more options. And this pack is also kind of boring. There's a Gideon, there's Sorin, which is fine. There's Phyrexian Metamorph, which is decent. Being able to copy anything is pretty sweet. Clones are generally pretty good. But this being the Holiday Cube, I mean, this can't copy artifacts, so I'm more of a fan of that. And so I'm going to go ahead and take this, and maybe one of these guys wheels. Maybe we go into blue-white, who knows. We'll just have to wait and see what colors we're getting past. And the Metamorph is going to make our deck pretty much regardless. Ooh. So it looks like blue is probably open, black's probably open, white may be open. But I'm going to go ahead and take Mind Stone. There's also a Sulfuric Vortex, which is quite good. Not in the fetch land, Phyrexian Metamorph, Phyrexian mana deck, though. So what I want to do is just take this Mind Stone and pass on this Compulsive Research. Research is not bad, but I do like Mind Stone a lot. And Ancient Grudge is pretty sweet, let me tell you about that. But I think we're going to go with Polluted Delta, because it looks like black is more open than... black and red are both pretty open, but Polluted Delta is one of my favorite fetch lands. And we already have Flooded Strands, so might as well go for completing the Onslaught cycle. And this pack is kind of mediocre. The Sneak Attack, so we could definitely go into some sort of Sneak Attack deck, seeing it this early. That would be something. That's kind of interesting. Maybe we can do that. The alternative is to take a Knight's Heath Familiar, Apocrysite, Archangel of Thune. Yeah, those are all pretty boring. Knight's Heath Familiar might actually be good. But Sneak Attack certainly is something. Sneak Attack is more adventurous. I think we can definitely do something with that. All sorts of tutors and whatnot, but I'm just going to be boring and take the Knight's Heath Familiar. Force of Will is not bad. We can take that. We can also take Prophetic Bolt, but I'm not really sure I'm red. I'd rather just take the Counterspell. Especially when broken things are going on, Force of Will is pretty sweet, so we'll just take that. And it looks like black is more open than white, so I'm going to go ahead and pick one of these black cards. Now we've got Bone Shredder and Liliana Vess. And Liliana Vess is a little on the slow side, to say the least. Bone Shredder's okay, but I generally like having more powerful cards, so I'm going to go with the Liliana. And Bone Shredder's fine. There's just a lot of cards that overlap with it. Ooh. Taiga? Let's see. That's a little bit off, so I think what we can go for is a Toxic Deluge. I do like Mesmeric Fiend, but Toxic Deluge is a pretty good Wrath of God, even though it does cost life, but I'm fine with that. And here we can take Inkeyes or Overgrown Tomb. I guess we can speculate on green, so I'll take the Overgrown Tomb. Not really going to play Inkeyes ever, so I'll just pass that along. And it's going to be kind of difficult to cast Broodmate Dragon, but I think we might be able to do it. Alternative is take Earthquake as another Wrath of God. That's kind of close. I think we will just go with a Broodmate Dragon. And a sideboard Lifebane Zombie. I guess red's also open, seeing that Sulfuric Vortex is wheeled. Out of that, or just no one drafts red in the Holiday Cube. And I suppose we can play Thawing Glaciers. It is pretty slow. Or there's a sideboard Black Knight. I think I'll go with the Thawing Glaciers, just in case we want to splash. And we can speculate on Sneak Attack. Excellent. Sneak Attack with Broodmate Dragon. Attack on for 4, get a 4-4 for free. That is value. So we can certainly do something like that. It actually felt like blue wasn't as open as I would have liked it to be, as it appeared. There were some blue cards that we ended up passing up on that were like first through fifth, and then it really trickled off, but we'll have to see for this pack. And Scroll Rack. Oh, that's good with Thawing Glaciers. It's an old combo. I used to do really cool things with that. Finally, it's been ages since I've opened a Mox. So what I think I'm going to do is just take that. There's Sphinx of Dwar Isle, Dreadbore, Ultimate Price. Not really interested in those. Mox Emerald is awesome. Let's just cast Broodmate Dragon, accelerates us. Moxen in general are pretty sweet. Mana acceleration is pretty sweet, which is why I took Mind Stone so highly. Warzov Signet. Ancient Tomb. Tinker. Tinker could be pretty good. It's pretty close. We've got a Hero's Downfall, Edict, Agony Warp, Hypnotic Spectre, Tinker, and Warzov Signet. And Ancient Tomb. Taking away our costs. If we ignore Sneak Attack and Broodmate Dragon, we've got 2s, 3s, 4s, Sideboard Lifebane Zombies, so our deck isn't really clear what it's doing right now. I feel like Tinker is probably going to be sort of hit or miss. I want to take either the Hero's Downfall or the Warzov Signet, and I think I'm just going to take the Hero's Downfall. I do like Warzov Signet, don't get me wrong. Don't get me wrong in the slightest, but I don't think Hero's Downfall is going to wheel, and it's certainly the kind of removal that I want because it deals with more difficult to deal with permanents. You could always take this Vraska, because that can, we've got a few sources of green, but I'm just going to take the Hero's Downfall. Mole Drifter, huh? Bristlebrand. Bristlebrand's pretty good with Sneak Attack. It's Tanglewire, Shadow Mage, Jungle Trier, Batterskull. It's a pretty good pack. Not really sure which one to take. There's Batterskull or Mole Drifter. I think those are the better cards. Or Shadow Mage. Shadow Mage can get blocked, though, I suppose. It's got Fear. And Fear is, it can't be blocked except by artifact creatures and black creatures. It's been a while since I've confused it with Intimidate. I think what I'm just going to do is going to take this Mole Drifter. I like it with, I like drawing cards. A little Batterskull, man, that card's cool. Oh well. So here, we've got a Fact or Fiction. Or we can take a Masticore, or an All is Dust. I think Fact or Fiction is going to be a little better. Like I said, drawing cards. Got to remember this. Play draw attack. And let's see, we have Floodish Trance, so we can get Sacred Foundry off of that. We can play Sower. Inferno Titan, that's pretty good with Sneak Attack. I think what I want to do is just take Sacred Foundry and speculate. What would we be able to do with that? I don't really like that much. I think I'm just going to take the Sower. Very boring. Well, this is certainly interesting. I do like Tamio. I also like Everflowing Chalice a lot. And it's kind of close, I think. Don't really have too much acceleration. We have Mind Stone, we have Mox Emerald. If we take Chalice, then we could possibly take Trinket Mage. Although Tamiyo does do stuff. But I certainly like the acceleration. Again, this is kind of close. I really don't like overloading my deck with a bunch of fives. I mean, we don't have to play Liliana. I guess we do. I'm just going to take the Overflowing Chalice. I like the acceleration. I like having access to faster starts and not having a deck full of clunky five drops that's just going to cause us to mulligan more often. And we're going to take an Aeon Chronicler. Or an Aeon Chronicler. There's Necromancy. That'd be good with Brood. Mage Dragon. Sneak attack it in, attack, get a dragon to keep, necromancy it, get two more dragons. Be the Dragon Master himself. I guess we can take Cryptic Command. The old Cryptic Command, Savannah, Fireblast deck, right? Let's see, between Delta and Strand, blue overlaps, we got two duels in the pack, that's crazy, but Cryptic Command is pretty sweet. And we'll just take a Boros Signet now. Take Dreadbore as a sideboard card. We have, I'm sure we could pick up a red land. Boros Signet is double off color. Yeah, I like picking up Dreadbore. And Agony Warp versus Hypnotic Spectre. We don't have too much going on, so I feel like we should be safe with taking the Spectre here. There's a Go for the Throat, and I'm sure we'll end up being okay. And Tangleware or Stomping Ground? Or Braids? Braids could be cool. Actually, no, I don't think Braids is going to be cool at all. I'm just going to take this Stomping Ground. And all is dust. No Master Cores here, please. Smokestack. All of the Braids, all of the time. Alright, so this deck is decidedly fair again. I mean, could try to just play a sneak attack deck, but seems, I don't know. Seems like it's much more difficult to do.